A while back, it was a rabbi within the liberal camp of Judaism, and he was simply asked, "What is God like?" And his response was that it doesn't really make any difference what we think God is like, that after we all dismiss and go home, we pay the babysitter. The thought was that it's just couples that speculate on the attributes of God as it were a campfire meeting or something, and that ultimately you can't know who God is. Now, the assumption that man has is that God has not left himself any way to be known. Jesus Christ said, "This is eternal life, to know thee, the only true God." The Apostle Paul said that he counted all things as loss, that he could know God. Now, is there a way to know God, or are we left to be at best as deist, that God has created us and left us here and we can't really know, and ultimately the fact of where I came from, of who I am, of what you are, of my relationship to the creation, the big issues of my duty and where death originated and sin comes from and how it's dealt with, and my assurance of life after death. Has God just simply not told us those things and has left us to wander down here? Are we at the mercy of the mystics and the New Age to go into their extrasensory perceptions through their meditations of who God is? Are we left to the spiritist to tell us who he is? If there is a God who is created and he is worth knowing, then that God has made himself known. You need to remember this about the Bible. Even though the Bible gives us rules, and even though the Bible shows us the plan of salvation, the Bible is preeminently not simply a rule book or a plan of salvation. The purpose of the Bible is that it's an autobiography of the author, of God. And within that, God tells us how this holy God deals with the sinner, and there is salvation. It tells us as to what God's will is for a human being to enjoy life as God intended it. But the ultimate purpose of this book is that it's an autobiography of God. And I heard a fellow tell me years ago, as a matter of fact, the same person that I spoke about his tour, Dr. John Hanna, he made the statement that to study man, to study history, to study anything, you start with God. And that if you don't know God, the absolute, you really can't understand man. You can't understand his duty. You can't understand man's psyche. You can't understand life as God intended it if you don't know God. And you can study all of those related areas, but if you don't know God, you have no frame of reference as to what they are. So theology proper, the study of the doctrine of God, his nature, attributes, his position, and his work, it's the queen of all sciences. And it's the essence of all maturity. You have to have a discipline in studying this. And it's been said, I'm doing this series kind of on a dare, because it's said that you can't teach this to the American church, that current 20th century American Christians are too shallow to learn theology. You always have to have some sort of dancing bear or some kind of highly visual thing to titillate a generation of Americans that have on television a 6-second attention span and read magazine material written to 14-year-old children. That's the American mind. And they tell you in a lot of seminaries that you can't use compound sentences, complex sentences. You can't use illustrations of anything that goes back over about past Ozzie and Harriet, because the American Christian can't handle it. Well, I don't believe that. And we're not going to do that. We're going to learn our theology.